device on the network together, that would work, and the same ideas for the protocols applies to that, to which protocols applies to the network, but I don't think I would use that very much. Alright, so Bluetooth by itself is a low cost, low power personal area network. And when I say personal area network, I mean kind of in between two people, about 1 meter to 100 meters on a very high power Bluetooth device. And it was meant to open up real estate for networks, because networks can't be used for everything, because that would introduce so much, bandwidth that no one would be able to use anything. So if you can imagine having every headphone you have connected to audio on a network, that would take up so much bandwidth in the space. Bluetooth is a great alternative to that, because it operates on a separate bandwidth and it's certain, channels that the network doesn't actually operate on. So, audio support for Bluetooth wasn't very strong because I wasn't developed for that. So, there have been a couple of protocols all throughout the years, but what I'm proposing is an actual dedicated system for Bluetooth audio, where I'm going to specify certain conditions and actually fine-tune the, devices myself. So my project objectives are to modify Bluetooth protocols and create a best effort audio packet. So kind of like UDP if you're familiar with networks. And then I want to use open source codecs for audio transport on limited bandwidth, and I plan to use GNU Radio, which is an open source software defined radio software for that. And I want to dedicate a Raspberry Pi device with advanced ADC and DAC for this high quality audio. I also want to achieve near real-time bit rates on Bluetooth audio connections. So for my methodology, we're going to start out where the actual applications are, in the application layer. So my goal is to connect audio equipment through Raspberry Pis and Bluetooth. So if we start off here and go down, you can see that there are a bunch of different layers in between this, and then we eventually get to L2 cap, which is what I want to work with, and the host controller interface, we actually get really low. So the host controller interface actually interacts with the, link manager and baseband layer, which are on the actual Bluetooth interface. So by modifying the L2 cap layer and the HCI layer with some programming tools and actual Linux tools, I can actually highly dedicate a specific device to sending just Bluetooth audio with low bit with low latency. So for my system design, I'm going to use Hi-Fi barrier add-on boards, which come with 24-bit quantizers, both EEC and DAX. And they will include this, they will increase the sound quality of the Pis to above average. As you can see, they kind of clip onto the Raspberry Pis here. I also want to modify the L2 cap socket code that's written in C, and I want to fine-tune the protocols in C++ so that when the Raspberry Pis communicate with one another, the actual communication is fast, like I said before. I will directly change like packet timeout in NTU, but I also dive into the Linux kernel with the IO control system call and modify stuff using that too. So I tried some code here. So I wrote an L2 cap socket class, and I encapsulated all the C code from the Blue Z library, which was the original Bluetooth implementation for Linux written in C. As you can see down here, I have some examples of me modifying the thing I said I would, like by setting the L2 cap purchasing these parts obviously tremendously increased my own effectiveness overall when I was doing this product. So that's why I kind of justified buying them, because even though they make the overall product more expensive, they also guarantee that it won't fail in most certain areas because they've been thoroughly tested. So in conclusion, Bluetooth protocols can be harnessed and improved upon quite a bit. The needs of a certain application can best be met using customized but rigid rules and modifications. L2CAP is a great protocol to start with, but I would like to go further in the future. The Raspberry Pis and SDR software are great for setting up communications and then modifying it and adjusting the filters. Naturally, obviously, having a complete real-time audio system with Bluetooth is going to be a lot of work, but with the right amount of testing and the right hardware and software, I think it's quite possible to develop a protocol that could do this in the future. Alright, any questions? Okay. In case you all were curious, I have some backup slides. So here, for example, shows the power classes for the Bluetooth, and as you can see, it goes up to 100 meters, like I mentioned, for the power class one, but it requires more power to send. Also goes into comparing the TCP/RF of common UDP L2CAP network Bluetooth protocols, an example, and shows you how they kind of work. Here's a bigger example of the GNU radio flowchart. So as you can see, using GNU, you can actually declare variables and modify them on the fly, and also connect the ins and outs of sync sources and actual audio filters together to form a sort of system in software, which is obviously why it's called software-defined radio. And last but not least, I wanted to give credit to GNU Radio because they are such a great software, and they're all open source. Everyone who submits modules to them, they're